Hello and welcome to the Zabil Stadium in Dubai for match day 4 of the AFC Asian qualifiers in the road to the FIFA World Cup 2022 in Qatar. I'm Brian Murgatroyd, and tonight it's hosts the UAE up against Iraq. And while we're only 3 games into a 10-match third round of qualifying, you have to say this match represents a must-win for both teams, and this is why. Both are winless, with 2 draws and a loss in 3 matches so far, and if they're going to secure a top 2 spot and an automatic qualification for Qatar, then 3 points is a must. UAE currently 3rd, as you've just seen, in the group, and 3rd place would give another shot at qualification via 2 playoffs. Here are conditions this evening. Humidity, not so bad actually. It's dropped considerably in the recent past, in the last couple of weeks. But the temperature, you can see the mercury there, quite high, so it's going to be testing for the players this evening. 3rd place in this group then would offer another shot at qualification via 2 playoffs. 1 against the 3rd place side in the other group, and then against a side from one of the other confederations. Crowd in this evening, and isn't it great to see all of last season here in the UAE was played behind closed doors because of the ongoing pandemic. All these supporters have all had their jabs, all had their PCR tests, and they're all here to enjoy themselves. As for the UAE and Iraq, well, between them, they've scored just once in their 3 outings in this third round, so both need goals tonight. In fact, Iraq yet to score any goals in this third round of qualification and have now gone more than 7 hours since their last strike. That was an own goal actually against Hong Kong in the penultimate match of round 2 of qualification. These supporters will really ensure we get a decent atmosphere here tonight. Everyone in celebratory mood, but who's going to be celebrating at the end of 90 minutes? Such an important game, particularly you feel for the UAE, because 3 of their first 4 matches in this 10-game group at home, and well, the first 2 of those they've only managed to pick up 2 points. It's an all-Dutch affair this evening. There's the 2 coaches, Bert van Marwijk and Dick Advocaat. They've been there, done it, got the t-shirt. Both, of course, have actually managed their home country, the Netherlands. Very shortly, the players on their way out. These two sides very close together in the FIFA rankings. The UAE 69th, Iraq 72nd. Actually played a game on this round in January, a friendly. That was 0-0. So another indication of how closely matched these two lineups are. So I think we can expect another closely contested and a tense night tonight, because there's so much at stake. Those two sides want to try and cut the gap to the top 2 places if they can. Players on their way out. The UAE in their home strip, their usual strip, the whites. Their fans love seeing them. Here come Iraq, playing in green tonight. What a cracking encounter this promises to be. South Korea and Iran, the top 2 sides in the group, have played already this evening. A 1-1 draw. Now we get ready for the national anthems. First of all, the national anthem of Iraq.
الجلال والجمال والسناء والبهاء في رباك في رباك والحياة والنجاة والسلام والنجاة في هواك في هواك الأراك الأراك سالما هناك يبلغ سما موطني.
Iraqi players singing with passion. And now the national anthem of our hosts for the evening, the United Arab Emirates. Singing from the UAE squad. Let's have a look at the two lineups then. And here is the UAE team. One change for them from the side that lost to Iran, with Keo Canedo, the Brazilian-born Alain forward, back after being on the bench for that defeat. Khalil Ibrahim drops to the bench. You can see that Keo is expecting to be just behind the forward Ali Mabkout. Here are the substitutes, and good news for the UAE is that Walid Abbas is fit enough for the bench after missing out on that Iran match. Ali Mabkout, incidentally, top scorer in these qualifiers, the AFC region, 12 goals for him. He's scored against Syria, the one goal the UAE have scored so far in this third round. Two captains, Ala Abdul Zahra waiting for Ali Kashif. Ali Kashif, the UAE skipper, and Ala Abdul Zahra in charge of Iraq. And our officials this evening, led by Ryuji Sato, the referee. And it's his third round match in these World Cup qualifiers. And on match day one, he was in charge of Iran against Syria. Match day two, South Korea against Lebanon. Here is the Iraq lineup, and it shows three changes from the 0-0 draw against Lebanon. Out go Ayman Hussein and Maitam Jabbar, who dropped down to the substitutes bench. On number 14, the influential Amjad Atwan misses out altogether. And in come number two, Ahmed Ibrahim, vastly experienced. He actually played on this ground for Al-Wasl. He missed out on the 0-0 draw against Lebanon. Number 10, Ala Abdul Zahra. And number 22, Ahmed Fadhil. They also come into the starting lineup. They know all about each other, to these two teams. Head to head, they've played 29 times, starting way back in 1973. In the recent past, the UAE have had the better of encounters. In the last nine matches, the UAE 6-2 ahead with one draw. Talk about experience, though. And there are three players starting for the UAE tonight, and two for Iraq, who played in the final of the Gulf Cup way back in 2013 against Stowe, took place in Bahrain. The UAE won that one 2-1 in extra time. Players, Ali Kashif, Ali Mabkout and Majid Hassan for the UAE, and for Iraq, Ali Adnan and Ahmed Ibrahim. So, we're almost ready to get underway. It's going to be Iraq who are going to get us started. And they're playing from right to left on your screens in the green strip. And with that result already this evening, with South Korea and Iran drawing, what that means for the group. So Iran go to 10 points, South Korea 8. So both these teams are 6 points behind. Shaheen Abdulrahman, number four. One of three players for the UAE this evening. He's one booking away from a suspension. The others, Majid Hassan, number eight, and Bandar Alibaby, number nine. He's hugging the touchline down below our commentary position. He'll be playing right wing back, Bandar Alibaby. Match day one here against Lebanon. He got into some pretty good positions actually. His delivery wasn't always what it should have been. Ball. Looking for Fabio Lima, this the UAE coach. Burkhan Marvik in his second spell. Attack was flying in early on. Opportunity perhaps now for the UAE to get into the danger area. Wriggling clear is De Lima. Cross comes in from Bandar Alibaby. And here's the chance. Well, should there have been a shot there by Abdullah Ramadan? Tried unselfishly to square the ball. Maybe it cried out for him to try and have an attempt on goal. That's a free kick. Clumsy challenge by Ibrahim Baish. Worrying times for Dick Advocaat. He's only been in charge for a couple of months. Look at this. This is really perhaps needed. Still a Ramadan to put his foot through that one. Free kick then for the UAE, and it's a free kick in a very good position indeed. And it's Abdullah Ramadan, the Al Jazeera player, who's over the ball now. He's going to whip this one in with his left foot. Instructions being screamed from the Iraqi bench. Six UAE players in the Iraq penalty area. Bandar Alibaby is short. Free kick's going to be taken to him. And it's whipped in towards the near post. Good defensive work in the end. It was the skipper, Ala Abdul Zara, who got across there to make the block, because that was heading in otherwise, I think. Cute angle, that free kick. Dick Advocaat. In his technical area already, sufficiently concerned with what he's seen, and he'll be concerned with that as well. Problem with the hip, possibly, for Ali Adnan. Viper player on the left, Ali Adnan. Wonderful left foot. Mahmoud Kamis, and Iraq can move away down at far side, the right hand side. Mohamed Ali Aboud. Have to go backwards though to the visitors. Mohamed Ibrahim, vice captain number two, gives the ball away. Theo Canedo. Tackled and fairly tackled in the end by Mohamed Ali Aboud. The UAE have it again. There's a player down, in fact. And on we go. Ali Mabkut was happy to stop playing, but the referee allowed the action to continue. In fact, play is still down. Very sportingly, the UAE have decided to stop playing. It's Ahmed Fadil, the young 21-year-old. See him lunging in there. Let's have another look from this angle. Oh, yes, that's nasty. Knee on knee. That will be painful. Looks as though there's a bit of swelling there already, actually. Yes, he's in quite a bit of discomfort. And the referee, Ryuji Sato, was happy to allow play to go on initially. when Ahmed Fadil stayed down. The UAE took it upon themselves just to stop playing. UAE fans making all the noise at the moment. Even though they lost their last match 1-0 to Iran, I think they'll be reasonably encouraged with the majority of their performance. Iran, certainly in terms of the FIFA rankings, vastly superior. Actually ranked 22nd to the UAE 69th, but for a long period of time the UAE gave as good as they got, before in the end Iran prevailed, followed by Mehdi Taremi, 20 minutes from time. Well, Ahmed Fadil's receiving treatment off the pitch, top of the screen, he's waiting to come back on, so that's a good sign. Referee's whistle goes, much to the chagrin of Majid Hassan, who's one of the players walking a tightrope this evening. The booking will see him suspended for the next match. Free kick taken short by Ali Fayez, who gets it back and decides to go back to his keeper Farhad Talib. Gets that one wrong. Bella Baby, a little give and go from him, trying to use his pace, but overcooks the first touch after he received the ball back. Been the question mark over him in these qualifiers in the third round, certainly his end product. Bert van Marwijk has overseen a real renaissance in the UAE in this second spell of his in charge. His first spell was almost forgotten since he's taken the job again. He's done very nicely. In fact, the UAE have enjoyed this venue under Bert van Marwijk. It's been Fortress Zabil until their recent defeat. Good dispossessed. Ball forward by Ali Aboud. Too long, in fact. Touch for Ali Kashif. UAE keeper. League champion Al Jazeera players in the squad. Six players in the UAE squad from the league champions, as Banda Al Abebe makes progress again. Gets the ball inside, but that's a poor ball, looking to find him again. There's an opportunity now though for Fabio de Lima. Tries to cut the ball across, another bite of the cherry. Picked away. Ahmed Ibrahim, the vice captain, none too pretty. Happy to get the ball somewhere, anywhere, as long as it's out of the danger area. Back in the side, big number two, making his presence felt. Missed that game against Lebanon. Actually played here for Al Wasl in the UAE Pro League. He's also played for Ajman, Al Dafra and Emirates in this country. Corner then for the UAE. Banda Al Abebe will have it. Got rid of eventually. In fact, it goes all the way back to Ali Kashif. Coming up to 10 minutes then. It's always going to be a cagey start, you felt. Lots of tension in the air. Both these teams understanding the importance of this fixture. Mentioned already that the UAE, three of their first four matches at home. So on the other side of the coin, two of their last three matches are away, including a game against Iraq. So it's really important for them to get points on the board early. They haven't done that so far. Flick on from Fabio de Lima. Dealt with though. Shaheen Abdulrahman, a breakdown in communication with Bandar Alibaby. Adnan, happy to take his time. You can see he's bathed in sweat. Humidity not too bad, but the temperature still in the low 30s. UAE, though, had to put up with worse than that in June on this ground. They won four games in a row to end up topping their group in round two. Still doesn't look all that comfortable, does he? Ali Adnan. Moving all that freely. So he had a problem with his hip earlier. And maybe the groin. He's going for the long throw here, though. Into the danger area. And it was pretty decent delivery. Rosada, the captain, getting in there. Actually getting the touch. A few question marks, I dare say, in the UAE defence about that. Ali Kashif under a bit of pressure, gets rid of the ball and does it well. Alibaby almost dispossessed. De Lima now up to this near side. Abdullah Salmin. Excitement around the number five. He's 20 years of age. In fact, he'll celebrate his 21st birthday in 6 days' time. Just his third start for the national team. Made his debut against Lebanon on match day one. Really good atmosphere. Ground nowhere near capacity. Capacity is up to 9,000 here at the Zabil Stadium, the home of Al Wasl. Perhaps best known in the recent past. And the one that was coached by the late great Diego Maradona for a season. Zara. Going to get the ball out to this near side to Ibrahim Baez, who's dispossessed. And then it's Bashar Rezend. Misplaced pass from him. Good skill from Mahmoud Kamis. Abdulrahman to the near side. Mohamed Alatas. And up to the far side, Mahmoud Kamis. See that Abdullah Salmin has come short. Thread a ball forward to De Lima. Taken instead by Ali Aboud. He's been an influential figure early on here for Iraq. Chance now on that far side for Rezan to try and get forward. And he's fouled. Caught down by Keo Canedo. Can't believe the decision. The assistant referee on that far side was adamant. Flag was up. Very quickly. You can see a tangle of feet more than anything. Maybe not a deliberate act by Keo. It's a good free kick position here for Iraq. UAE fans doing their best to put the kicker off. Oh, it really was great delivery. It's pinball at the moment in the UAE area. Shot comes in the end, but it's more or less dealt with and cleared in the end by Majid Hassan. Ball's ricocheting around there wickedly. Good run from Abdul Kadim. And the UAE break now. Long ball from De Lima. Ali Mabkut, down he goes under challenge. Well, the UAE fans were absolutely insistent that should have been a penalty. The referee was right on the spot, in all fairness to him. Ryuji Sato, he said No dice, but VAR's got to check this. Let's have a look at that free kick. It was a wonderful delivery from Rezan. He just couldn't get it clear, the UAE. Here is penalty appeal at the other end. Well, there's certainly contact there. It's a clumsy challenge from Mohamed Ali Aboud. And he's caught the man, not the ball, from that angle. It certainly looks a good claim for a penalty. Let's see what VAR make of it. VAR official Hiroyuki Kimura, another Japanese official. But in the end, he decides nothing doing and will stick with the referee's original decision. Well, no cliche, you've seen them given. Far too long delivery. Long ball from Ali Fayez. Well, Dick Advocaat. Nervous moments for him early on. Amazing to think he's been around as long as he has. 74 years young now. His 74th birthday last month. De Lima can't keep that in play. Dick Advocaat taking over from Shreko Katanek in August. Katanek, a former UAE coach. Both these coaches actually have had a modicum of success with their home country. Advocaat taking the Netherlands to third place in Euro 2004 in Portugal. And let's not forget that Dick Advocaat took the Netherlands to the final of the 2010 FIFA World Cup. And they lost 1-0 to Spain. Good skill from Mabkut. Tries to flick the ball inside to Keo Canedo. Can't do so. He's back to the action now. There's Ibrahim Baish. He's done well there. Not a good ball though, and it's well cut out by Shaheen Abdulrahman. Long ball punched forward by Ahmed Ibrahim. Too long though, and little flop from Banda Alababi gets the free kick. Bashar Rezan can't quite believe the decision's gone against him, but it has. Both these teams struggling for form in the recent past. Incredible, actually, the way that form's turned around, and not for the good either. No win in four for them. And that was after they'd been unbeaten in 19 matches. Including 8 draws and 11 wins. For the UAE, no win in three for them. Those failures to secure a victory coming in this third round of qualifying. And that was after 6 wins in a row. Both these sides capable of producing good form. Question is, can they produce it here this evening? Camus with the ball up the line. No change there for Keo Canedo. He feels he's been fouled. Actually, in the end, Mawi coming off worst in the challenge, it appears. Right back. This, he got his boot trodden on inadvertently by Keo. That's got to be a foul. No problems there. And Zara. Really mistimed challenge from him. Pitch quite slick. It was watered about 90 minutes before the start. see in places it's just cutting up a little bit. It's a very good surface here, it always is, at the Zabil Stadium. It's been very much the preferred venue for the UAE in the recent past. Here, seen 7 wins, 2 draws, and that defeat against Iran. Marvik, not happy with what he's seen there. And Marwi, 25-year-old right back, he's got pace to burn. Seen too much of it as yet, though. Number 17. An opportunity, though, for Iraq on this near side. Pin by Ish, checks back. Adnan, nice little cute ball, really. And down goes Sharif Abdul Kadim. I don't think he's too impressed, the referee, by that performance. First yellow card of the evening goes for diving. Number 18 for the visitors. It's his second start in the World Cup qualifiers. The leg was certainly put out by Shaheen Abdulrahman, but it would be fair to say that Sharif Abdul-Kadim made the most of it. First yellow card of the evening then. Malika Sheath with a long clearance for the hosts. Absolutely furious at the edge of his technical area. He felt the decision there should have gone in Iraq's favour. It didn't. Lima thought about the throw. In fact, now Banda El Abebe is being asked to take the throw 10 metres back from where Lima was contemplating taking it. Got in possession, just squandered. It will be an Iraq ball. Just over halfway then through this first half. Fakhar on his feet. He's coached over 1,100 games of professional football. 5 years older than his opposite number. And Marvik. Bounce dealt with by Shaheen Abdulrahman. Little flop again there from Banda El Abebe. He doesn't get the free kick this time though. It's Van Marvik's turn to be on the edge of his technical area, furious at something he's seen. Throw in then. Ali Adnan will take it. COVID protocol still in place. To take the clean ball. Long throw. Not for the first time this evening we've seen that. It's a real threat to what Iraq have got. Well, they're almost 8 hours since they've scored a goal. Over Banda El Abebe's head, and now an opportunity for Ibrahim Bayish on this near side. Shows it to El Abebe. They're happy to try and pass their way out of trouble in their own penalty area, the UAE. And the Iraqi fans happy with what they're seeing in terms of the pressing by the visitors. Ibrahim Bayish again. And this time, discretion's the better part of valour, and the long clearance comes in. Peo Canedo can't win that one in the air. won by Ibrahim. Could it spell this for Iraq? Oh, and goodness me, Tani Shaw there. But, Ibrahim Baish realised how much time he had. Another look at the action here. Here is Baish driving into the penalty area. It was his shot. But, just before that, UAE were just sitting off Iraq, and it almost cost them dearly. Statistics there in the top left-hand corner of your screen make interesting reading, don't they? Even though Iraq have been struggling for goals, they're still prepared to take a pot shot, show some confidence. Fahad Talib then with a long clearance. Gone in the air by Abdullah Ramadan, to no great effect. And that'll be a free kick to Iraq. Sharif Abdul Kadim ending up as the meat in a UAE sandwich between Abdullah Ramadan and Mahmoud Khamis. In a very nice position here for the visitors. Ali Adnan is over the ball. And a couple of his teammates. So he's going to be left to it. Here's Ali Adnan. Lovely left foot, this man. What can he do with it? Dinks it into the danger area. And in the end, that's a good defensive header. It was Keo Canedo back there, picking up the scraps. Another look here. In fact, Mohamed Al-Attas was the man who got his head to it. Comfortably gathered by Ali Kashif. On this near side, Ali Adnan. They pushed over to the far side by Ali Aboud. Up now. Ali Aboud once more. Set up the ball. That's really good defensive work from Mohamed Al-Attas. He wanted to know if the assistant referee's flag was going to go up. See there quite clearly. Good decision. Ala Abdul Zahra. Captain just straying into uncharted territory beyond the last defender. Good pressing from Iraq, forcing the UAE to go backwards. Shaheen Abdul Rahman. Ball from him. By number 8, Ibrahim Baish, his sixth start this World Cup qualifying campaign. Given away and picked up by Majid Hassan. Spread over to the far side. Mahmoud Khamis. Keo Canedo. Pass Anderson from the UAE. Happy to be patient. One ball in the end by Shaheen Abdulrahman. Cut out by Ali Adnan. Just over half an hour gone. Still we await the first serious effort on goal. Both these coaches have been asked about the significance of this match, whether it is a must-win game. Of course, they'd never say that publicly, but I think in their heart of hearts they both know that it is. Certainly if they have top two aspirations. Lima. Down the line to the Salmin. Tries to get the cross over. Well, that's a terrible piece of defending. And Ali Adnan gets away with it. What on earth he was attempting to do there, I can only imagine. Really wasn't the place for a spectacular overhead to try and clear the ball. Needed something far more orthodox than that. He almost paid the price. It could have gone anywhere, that, in the end, thankfully for him. And ended up in the grateful hands of Fahad Talib. Goalkeeper who will celebrate his 27th birthday in 9 days' time. Of clean sheets for him already. And this round three of the World Cup qualifiers. That's good skill from Rezan getting through. And in the end, it was a good run as well from Abdul Zahra, the captain. He was confronted by Ali Kashif. Made the most of things. Timed his run perfectly there. The ball just got away from him a little bit, didn't it? Just skidded on, perhaps, on the surface. Sliced off the outside of his left foot. Sadiq Kashif came to close him down. It's a good surging run from Banda Alababi. He's continued it. Another good run from Majid Hassan. He's continued his run as well. And here's Sir Keir. He scored. Yes! 1-0. Oh, terrific stuff from the UAE. Surging runs, and in the end it was KO back in the side tonight. He's found the back of the net. He gambled, he burst into the penalty area, the loose ball broke to him, and that's a terrific strike. It's his fourth goal for the UAE, and his first since the strike against Thailand on this ground in June. Good run from Majid Hassan. The ball broke to Keo Kaneda, perhaps a little fortunately. Deflected off Abdullah Salmin. But Keo had burst into the area. You see his run now. Here he comes. Timed it perfectly and thumped it with his right foot into the roof of the net. It's his favoured foot, the right foot, and he shows why. Cracking finish. And the UAE, they can celebrate, their fans certainly can. A well-worked goal. A goal born of positivity. Majid Hassan's run there. Demanded some end product, and in the end it got it. So KO's goal, just the second for the UAE in this third round of qualification. And a much needed tonic for them. Here's Majid Hassan. What a terrific surging run that was from him. Side flag going up. Good positive stuff there though from the UAE, and they got their reward. So what have Iraq got in response? Coming up to 8 hours now since their last goal. Going to have to find one here this evening if they're going to get something out of the match now. Such a crucial game for both teams. It's the UAE who've drawn first blood. Square ball from Ali Aboud, picked up by Ahmed Ibrahim. Tackled there, Ahmed Fadil. Good to see him up and about on a yellow card. Yellow card issued to Abdullah Salmin for his challenge on Sharif Abdul Kadim. A UAE player this evening. And the second overall shown by Mr. Sato. Well, squandered that free kick for Iraq. They've got another bite of the cherry now, though. Picked up by Fadil, who lofts the ball forward. Cut out by Mahmoud Kamis. Long ball from Abdullah Ramadan, too long in the end for Ali Mahmoud, who's feeding off scraps at the moment. It's a frustrated figure, you saw a shake of the head there. Top scorer in the second round of qualifiers, with 11 goals, but just the one so far in this third round. It was against Syria on match day two. And it owed an awful lot that one to of areas at the back by the Syrians, who still managed to get a draw out of that game. It's a decent opportunity for Iraq, just over the captain's head. Better ball there from Alaa Marwi. Potentially, it could have been trouble for the UAE. There's an opportunity though, the ball squared by Rezan, taken away from an attacker by Shaheen Abdulrahman. Mahmoud Kamis, and they're happy to play in their own third of the pitch around their penalty area, the UAE. Mahmoud Kamis. As you expect, you can see at the top of your screen there the UAE fans in boisterous mood. Find their voices, not that they ever lost them, but that goal has certainly been a real fillip for them. Up to this near side, Abdullah Salmin. Side to Majid Hassan. Mahmoud Kamis down the line. A little back heel cute from the goal scorer, Keo Canedo. A bit too cute, really, though. And Alabebi to Ramen. Period of consolidation here for the UAE. Okay. The host is happy to invite the Iraq press. I hope they're creating space further up the pitch. Nice little touch by Abdullah Salmin. Good run from Abdullah Ramadan. In the end, no end product from it. But, UAE retain possession. Ramadan again. To Lima. Salmi. controlled fractionally, a poor ball actually that Mikel Fernandez had to deal with. Here's the possession statistics. A lot of that possession though for the UAE, 70% of the ball that they've seen in this first half, hasn't really been in forward areas. It's been a lot of possession like this in their own half, which is not really hurting Iraq. Of course, the UAE now have the advantage of that goal. Cleo Canedo has to slip the ball inside, nothing doing there. Header away from Baesh. Good tackle, very good tackle indeed that from Majid Hassan. Ramadan forward. Keo dispossessed. A chance on his near side for a run for Ibrahim Baesh. Missed by Majid Hassan. And then by Abdullah Salmin. Ali Aboud across to shot from Abdul Kadim. Well over the top. For the pump defensively there for the UAE, you can see that in the end Ali Mabkut was racing back trying to close down Abdul Kadim. Abdelkar cutting a frustrated figure, a bit of pressure coming to Naut. Three minutes then of normal time remaining at the end of this first half. Already that Iran and South Korea, the two table toppers in this group, have played already. It's finished 1-1. The other match in this group on match day four, Group A, it's Syria against Lebanon. Lebanon fourth in the table, Syria bottom of the shot with just 1 point. The point came against UAE in match day two. B, which has been completed already. Japan beating Australia 2-1 to close the gap to Australia and Saudi Arabia at the top of the table. Other matches today, Oman against Vietnam and Saudi Arabia against China. China beat Vietnam in their last outing here in the UAE. So half an hour's drive away from here north. In Sharjah. It's match day three. Just into play there. And down goes Rezan. Theatrically, in the opinion of the referee. Then the UAE can't take advantage. And bursting forward now is Ali Aboud. Looking for support. Can you find it on that far side? Danger area again, headed away by Alatas. Alababy now trying to use his pace on this near side. Gets some chicks back. Trying to get away from Ibrahim Baesh. It's been a good battle between those two in the first half. On this near side. This evening, Yusuke Araki. Some more Japan match officials list tonight, and we await Yusuke Araki's verdict on how many minutes we're going to play at the end of this first half. And Alababy on the run. Time to measure his cross. Can't get past the first defender. Forward by Majid Hassan. Just kept in play by Alamawi. It's going to be 3 minutes. You can see at the bottom of your screen there. Yusuke Araki holding up his board. There's an opportunity on this near side now. Abdul Zahra, the captain, into the penalty area. Lays the ball back. shot from Baez, and in the end, comfortable enough for Ali Kashif. Just deflecting off the legs of Shaheen Abdulrahman. Information in the top left-hand corner of your screen about the minimum number of minutes to be played. Luke van Marwijk will be a relatively happy man with what he's seen so far. Bear in mind, on match day two, the UAE were a goal up at half-time. And then could only draw against Syria. So he certainly won't be counting his chickens until the 90 minutes is up. And his side can get those 3 points. Picked up now by Rezan on that far side. Marwi. Rezan. Gets the cross in. Oh, and there was an opportunity, wasn't there, for Abdul Zahra, and he knows it. First time snap shot. Got away from the defender. In fairness, he was being closed down quite quickly by Shaheen Abdulrahman. But it was a chance. And that reaction reflects the fact. That's better from Iraq. Most of their threat in this first half is down the left-hand side, primarily through Ibrahim Baish. Long clearance, straight to Sharif Abdullah Kadim. In the end, it's Rezan on that far side. He was dispossessed by Mahmoud Kamis. And now there's an opportunity, plenty of space, in fact, for Abdullah Salmeen to run into. Ali Mabkut tries to flick the ball back to the youngster. Can't find him. Ali Mabkut, you can see there, giving a little bit of applause to his young teammate. Encouragement, because he was happy with that. Nicely cut out by Banda Alabebi. Followed by Abdullah Ramadan. Gets the ball back. And in fact, that's the last action of this first half. It's a first half that's yielded one goal from that man there, Keo Canedo. His fourth goal for the UAE, and it came on 32 minutes after a surging run from Majid Hassan. Keo back in the side this evening and taking advantage of the fact to thump the ball into the roof of the net from close range. And that is the goal that separates these two sides. Iraq have been on the back foot for periods. The UAE have dominated in terms of possession, but in all fairness, they haven't really threatened a great deal. But they've got the all-important goal, and it is important because both these sides, remember, chasing their first victory of this third round of World Cup qualification. Sebastian Tagliabue on the side. Here are the statistics of the first half, and you can see that the UAE have bossed that possession, and in terms of the amount of time they've had on the ball as well, number of passes. Iraq's passing accuracy, well, it leaves a bit to be desired, doesn't it? And they're going to have to do a lot more in the second half if they're going to get something out of this match. Half-time then, it's the UAE 1, Iraq 0. We'll be back with the second half shortly. Welcome back to the Zabil Stadium. I'm Brian Murgatroyd, bringing you all the action here from this encounter in Group A of the third round of the AFC World Cup qualifiers, the road to Qatar. And you can see words there from Ala Abdul Zahra to his players, because it's Iraq in the green. We're going to have to do the chasing in this second half. They're a goal down, thanks to Keo Canedo's fourth goal for his adopted country. Very little to choose between these two sides over the years. This is the 30th time they've met. UAE have won 9, Iraq have won 10, and there have been 10 draws. UAE on their way back out. Ali Mabrouk, the number 7, very much a talismanic figure for his country. Goal scorer extraordinaire, top scorer in the domestic league last season. He's been high scorer in domestic football for many years now. On the brink of becoming all-time top scorer in UAE football. He's actually the UAE's all-time top scorer as well. 4 goals in the last edition of the Asian Cup. 5 goals in the edition before that. That was in Australia when the UAE finished third. He was the top scorer in the tournament. keep our eyes peeled for any changes by either team at half time. It doesn't appear though there are. So it looks as though it's as you were. Ali Kashif, skipper for the UAE this evening. The goalkeeper just calling all the players together, rallying the troops, getting ready for a big 45 minutes. Both these teams chasing their first victories of this third round of qualification. And both of them trying to track down the two sides at the top of the table, Iran and South Korea, who are in the automatic qualification places at the moment. It's the UAE then who get us underway in this second half, playing from right to left on your screens, the whites. They've been to just one World Cup in their history, and that was in 1990. And ahead of the group stages, losing to Colombia, West Germany and Yugoslavia. Not qualified since. Iraq, they've won by the cherry as well in the FIFA World Cup finals. 1986 in Mexico. It's their day in the sun up to this point in time. Again, they went out at the group stages, losing all three matches they played, narrowly, it must be said. 1-0 to Paraguay, 2-1 to Belgium, 1-0 to the hosts, Mexico. So what have Iraq got in the tank in this second half? Out to this near side then. Maui, right back into the danger area. The scraps are picked up though by Fadil. And in the end, it's the skipper, Abdul Zahra, who was swinging a boot at that one. Drilled across by Maui. He was hoping for some sort of ricochet or a bit of fortune. It didn't come his way. Still, it's a throw into Iraq on the far side because the ball did come off the UAE player. We're just checking, actually. Did it come off a hand? Let's have a look. So a hand in the build-up, perhaps, to the action. Checking that challenge there as well by Mahmoud Kamis. All's fine. On we go. Headed clear by Mohamed Al Attas. And a free kick to Iraq. Abdul Kadim is down. The referee was right on the spot. He said, the hand there you can see from Abdullah Salmin. The youngster's been booked already. Inadvertent though that one may have been. Still enough to draw the ire of the referee. So this is a terrific position here for Iraq, right at the start of the second half. See if they can get back on level terms. Free kick maybe just over 25 yards out. Looks as though who's lining it up is Abdul Zahra, the captain. 17 goals for Iraq, his most recent in May against Nepal. Drives it in. Oh, that's disappointing. And he knows it. Shake of the head. He was trying to get it under the wall as the wall jumped. He was hoping to get the ball under those jumping figures. Actually scored against the UAE in November of 2019 before the ongoing pandemic. That was in the Gulf Cup. 2-0 victory for Iraq on that occasion. The tournament brought the curtain down on Bert van Marwijk's first spell as UAE head coach. Really undistinguished spell it was too, but he was given a second bite at the cherry and he's made a great fist of things this time. Baby whips the ball inside. way back to Ali Kashif. Again, they're happy to play with the ball on the edge of their area. You could argue they're playing with fire, but they've got the confidence to do that. They can create space further up the pitch. That ball's given away, though. It's a good run, this, from Baez. Far too casual, though, by Fadil, giving the ball away. Is that a late challenge, possibly, on De Lima? A whistle from the referee, and then Iraq get possession back. Just about 5 minutes gone in the second half. And switched by Ali Abu to that far side. He gets the ball back in the centre circle. Up from Ali Fayez, he goes long, easily cut out from Shaheen Abdulrahman's right foot. Flattering challenge on De Lima, who goes down, nothing given. Subsequent free kick is taken quickly. Ali Mabkut out on the margins. He's got Abdullah Salmin joining him. Mahmoud Kamis on this near side below our commentary position. Again, they're happy to knock it around. And Alabebi on that far side. And the lion's share of possession in that first period. The UAE, 70% of the ball they had. Salmin. Ali Mabkut, does he get any change there? No, he doesn't. Easily cut out by Mawi. Kamis, the Al-Wada player, is actually there on loan from Al Nassr at the moment. Vastly experienced. That's a good run, this, by Rezan. But in the end, he's crowded out. He's got some good tricks, Bashar Rezan, 24-year-old midfielder. Had his debut as a teenager against Peru. A flick from the goal scorer, Keo Canedo, to Mabkut. Far side, Banda Alabebi. Mabkut again. Ramadan. To his teammate Mabkut, who misses his kick completely. Frustration for him in this third stage of qualifying. There was that cute back heel. Frustration for Ali Mabkut. Near side, Baez trying to get the ball across. Complicated clearance from Alatas. Ali Abu to the near side. And it opened up there, really, didn't it, for Baez, and he couldn't take advantage of it. Mabkut just come deep to receive, lays the ball back. Ramadan. Mabkut again. UAE fans won't want to see that. Him deep in his own half. De Lima setting Banda Alabebi through. And yes, Mabkut! Oh, goodness me! What a great run from Ali Mabkut. In the end, it was fractions wide. Really haired forward, though, because he was deep in his own half. He got the touch on it. Agonisingly close. Close isn't quite good enough as far as the UAE are concerned. A change then for Iraq. The first change this evening. And coming on is Ayman Hussein, the number nine. He replaces Sharif Abdul Kadim, who was booked in the first half, you might remember. First touch there for Ayman Hussein. He's taken up position around the penalty spot now. A good surging run from Maui. And in the end, good defence from Abdullah Salmin. Concedes the corner, though. Here's the near miss again. Full stretch there, Ali Mabkut. He really made huge amounts of ground there to get into the penalty area. And it couldn't have been any closer, could it, without ending up in the back of the net. Corner, though, for Iraq now. What can they do at the other end? Could have been 2-0. Is it going to be 1-1? Captain Abdul Zahra getting his head to the ball, but it's off target. Ayman Hussein, who's come on as a substitute for Iraq, 25 years of age. It's his third substitute appearance in this campaign. And that includes the second round as well. Four starts too. De Lima finds the ever-willing Bandar Alabebi. He does well there. And Iraq were convinced the ball had crossed the line before he tried to get his cross in. It was blocked by Ali Adnan. And the referee's assistant on that far side pointed to the corner. So end-to-end stuff at the moment. Both sides playing with a fair degree of abandon. Then, which Bandar Alabebi will take on the far side of the pitch. Ever the willing runner, goes short with the corner. It was a wasted effort really, wasn't it? The scraps have been picked up. Pushing header, and down goes Ali Mabkut. The assistant referee on that far side, signalling for offside. Pushing header from Keo Kaneda, but you can see Ali Mabkut well beyond Ahmed Ibrahim. So whether he was fouled or not became immaterial. Indirect free kick for the offside, indicated by the referee, and a long clearance from Fahad Talib. Last goal scored by an Iraqi player was Safa Hadi against Cambodia. That was in Riffa. It was on the 7th of June this year. It was only 500 minutes ago now. Really struggling in the absence of Mohanad Ali Kadim Al Shamari, known as Mimi. Regular goal scorer for them. But in the absence, it's the referee given here on the free kick. And a yellow card for Shaheen Abdulrahman. And that means he's going to be suspended for the next match, and he knows it. You can see his reaction. Clumsy challenge just outside the area. So, the UAE's next match against South Korea away from home. One of the toughest assignments in the group, and they'll have to make do without Shaheen Abdulrahman for that encounter. That match to be played on the 11th of next month. They've got more immediate concerns now. Those concerns are a free kick just fractionally outside the penalty area. five players in the wall for the UAE. And over the ball is Ali Fayez. He steps, oh, good save. Great reaction stop. Ali Kashif, he must have seen that so late. It was straight at him, but he had to get his fist up. Good strong hands and punches it over the bar. Closest Iraq have come to a goal. Ali Kashif, the UAE captain, denies them. Oh, but he misjudges that corner, just gets enough on it to get it away from the danger area. Oh, and the referee gives a free kick now for that challenge by Fabio Lima. Man going down, Ahmed Fadil. Just a tangle of legs, really. Here's that free kick once more. You could argue it's straight down the throat of Ali Kashif, but it was hit with power. And he would have seen it late, but he was equal to the task. Vastly experienced three-time winner of domestic league title here, Ali Kashif, with his club side Al Jazeera. Free kick then. Rezan to take it, but the referee's blown his whistle just before the free kick was about to be taken for some argy-bargy in the penalty area. Referee deeming it six of one, half a dozen of the other. You can see all sorts of pushing and shoving, even some Iraq players pushing their own players. And a flick header in the end. It was Ahmed Ibrahim who got that flick header, but it's wide of the mark. In fact, in the end, I think it was Ahmed Fadil. All the momentum was against him there. He was going away from goal as he got his head to the ball. Just over an hour gone. UAE captain and the referee just having a little bit of a chat. Good atmosphere here this evening. It's a little flick on by Ali Mabkut. Starts another attack for the UAE. Abdullah Ramadan out to the far side. De Lima breaks the challenge, but he can't get the ball past. Bashar Rezan, he was there. Good work again from Rezan. In the end, Abdullah Ramadan wins the throw-in for the UAE. To this near side to Mahmoud Kamis. Nado, the goal scorer. A bit of pushing and shoving with Maui. Yes, looking for the return ball, doesn't get it from the substitute, Ayman Hussein. Nado again, good holding from him. And in the end, a little check. Sufficient by Ahmed Ibrahim to bring the free kick. It's good battling play there, though, by Keo Canedo. He's back to the defender, retained possession nicely and tried to break out of a pretty cramped area. De Lima inside to Ramadan. Mabkut in the area and terrific defending. Ahmed Ibrahim, oh, he's done well there. Perhaps you could argue the ball didn't come down for Mabkut as he would have wanted, but Ahmed Ibrahim got himself between the attacker and the ball very promptly indeed. And now Iraq can come forward on this near side through Maui. On the edge of the area, Rezan. Down he goes with a scream of pain. He's still down. Nothing was given by the referee, and Mabkut very sportingly puts the ball out of play to allow treatment. for the injured Iraq player. Let's have a look at what happened here from this angle, see if we can see more clearly. Yes, that would have hurt. Inadvertent from Mohamed Al Attas, but studs on the side of the boot. Boots these days certainly aren't as substantial as they used to be. Here's that effort from Ali Mabkut. He couldn't quite bring it down. His first touch let him down a little bit, didn't it? Still, really good defending from Ahmed Ibrahim to get back so quickly. Here was the first touch. Just got away from him, the ball, didn't it? But look how quickly Ahmed Ibrahim was on the scene. Mabkut happy with the distribution, though. When you're watching these replays, the players taking the opportunity of the treatment for Bashar Rezan to have some water, get some fluid into them, because the temperature's still hovering around the 30 degree mark. It's hot. And nice to see that after Mabkut put the ball out of play, Ibrahim Bayesh gives the ball back to the hosts. So about 25 minutes to go. What have we got in store, I wonder? Two groups of six teams left in this AFC Asian qualifiers, the road to Qatar. This group, Iran, Iraq, South Korea, Lebanon, Syria and the UAE. The UAE can come forward again now through De Lima, using his shoulder to barge over the defender. De Lima again, looking for someone to have made a run. Nobody did. It's his home ground here, Fabio De Lima. He's an Al Wasl player. Group B. Of these World Cup qualifiers, Australia, China, Japan, Oman, Saudi Arabia and Vietnam. Top two sides in each group go forward automatically to Qatar 2022. Third place sides, they play off against each other. Whoever wins that game goes into playoff. Oh, it's into the side netting. Perhaps Fadil will reflect on the fact that he could have taken a bit more time here. The header from Mahmoud Kamis. Maybe a little bit more composure. He was bouncing away from him. He tried to hook his right foot round it. Sadiq Abdullah prowling his technical area now. Beginning of August, taking over from Sreko Katanec, former UAE coach, who was in charge for over 3 years, the Slovenian. Took this Iraq side to the semi-finals of the Gulf Cup in Qatar, and runners-up in the West Asian Football Federation Championship. Free ball looking for Mabkut. That's easy enough for Ahmed Ibrahim to cut out. Long ball looking for the substitute, Ayman Hussein. Doesn't find him. Ping pong at the moment between these two teams. Can someone get a grip? Majid Hassan inside to De Lima. Canedo comes short. Bounces off the defender, contemplates a shot. This was a give and go with Mabkut, but the give wasn't all that accurate. So it was no go. Cut out easily enough by Majid Hassan, who goes down under challenge. Frustration for Ibrahim Bayesh. So he just caught the left ankle or the left foot of Majid Hassan. Majid Hassan has stayed down. Here's the goal. It was his run that really was the catalyst That and the fact that Keo Canedo made that run, an angled run into the penalty area, gambled on the ball coming his way, and it did. And there's the celebration by the player and by the fans. Capture for posterity and for social media too. Haven't had an awful lot to cheer so far in this round three of the qualifying campaign, UAE supporters. I'll take that though. And Alababi, oh, that's a lovely skill from him. Out to De Lima on the far side. More through to Mabkut, Ali Mabkut. Oh, it's a save from Farhad Talib. That was the opportunity that he was looking for. It was the opportunity that the UAE were looking for. But in the end, there wasn't a whole lot of conviction in that finish, was there? And it was straightforward enough for the Iraqi stopper to get down and gather comfortably. Well, will that be costly in the final analysis, I wonder? There's Iraqi coming forward now. Maui on this near side always slipped at the vital moment. And Mahmoud Kamis can tidy up. Abdullah Salmin was just caught there. And two more changes for Iraq. Tariq and also Amir Al-Amari. And they're replacing Ali Adnan. Deal has gone off as well. So a corner on that far side to Iraq. Easy enough for Ali Kashif. So three changes so far for Iraq. No changes as yet for the hosts. Side by Esh. Is that one of the substitutes? And Mario, it's in, yes! Oh, goodness me, out of absolutely nothing. I think the final touch was off Mohamed El Attas. The Iraqi supporters ecstatic. Oh, tragedy for the hosts. And Iraq a level. Let's have another look at it here. It was a hopeful ball that was flicked in. And in the end, it just came off the top of Mohamed El Attas's head. Frustration for the UAE, and it was Amir Al-Amari who got the cross in. Virtually his first touch after coming on. And a significant touch too, wasn't it? But not as significant as the one by Mohamed El Attas, just glancing off the top of his head. And there's the reaction from the Iraqi supporters. Well, it really sets up a grandstand finish now, doesn't it? And Iraq, do they fancy an opportunity of winning this? And both sides searching for their first victories in this third round of qualifiers. Well overcooked. Goodness me. They've offered virtually nothing going forward. And Iraq, not too many threats on goal. And another own goal. Second consecutive own goal has been credited to them. Their last goal in competitive action was in the penultimate match of round two. That was an own goal for Hong Kong. Just dawdling on the ball there, the substitute, Ayman Hussein. So Robert van Marwijk contemplate a change now, with his side pegged back inside by Abdullah Salmin to Ali Mabkut. And all of a sudden that miss from Mabkut looks even more significant, doesn't it? 1-0, he could have doubled the advantage, and now all of a sudden it's 1-1, and here's the change that is coming. And it's going to be Khalfan Mubarak who's going to come on. Another Al Jazeera player waiting in the wings. Started all three matches for the UAE. Qualifying in June here. The UAE really did come home with a wet sail to end up topping their group. He's coming on for the youngster Abdullah Salmin. From the Barak, so Abdullah Salmin's race is run this evening. Made his debut way back in 2016 for the national team against Jordan when he came on as a substitute then. 26 years of age, and he's on the ball now. Knocks it out to Banda Alabebi. To Lima, it's inside. It's in his box of tricks. Rajid Hassan. And again. Forward by the substitute. And in the end, fly hacked clear by Ahmed Ibrahim. Okay, Pinedo going for that aerial challenge. Given away by Abdullah Ramadan. And Iraq can come forward again. Good tackle from Majid Hassan. He's pumped up. Cleanly there, and he had to as well. Another one of the UAE players, one booking away from suspension. Is that a push in the back from Mahmoud Khamis? Iraq certainly thought so. Nothing given, and in fact, free kick in the end goes the UAE's way. Another change coming now for them. Walid Abbas. He's come on in place of the man who scored the own goal, Mohamed Al Attas, who I'm sure will be absolutely crestfallen. It's good news for the UAE to have Walid Abbas back, particularly given Shaheen Abdulrahman's impending suspension. Walid Abbas, vastly experienced, winning his 98th cap this evening. His debut back in 09 against Germany. The last game against Iran. And the treble here in the UAE last season. There's Iraq come forward once again. Shot comes in, but, straight at Ali Kashif. Shot from Rezan. To Lima. Astanouan in particular, and Iraq can come forward now through Baesh to the far side. Rezan they switch to this near side. Maui, the right back. What's his quality of delivery like? Lacking on that occasion, although Mahmoud Kamis got the touch. And a slip then from Maui. Two more changes being contemplated by Dick Advocaat. This will be the final changes for him if they go ahead. Safa Hadi is waiting to come on, and so is Sherko Karim. Safa Hadi, a defensive midfielder, actually will have his 23rd birthday in 2 days' time. On ball, Banda Alababi keeps it in play. Deep cross towards Mabkut, punched away by Talib, and now all of a sudden Iraq can look to be positive on this near side. Check back from Bayesh. In the end, he squanders possession. The changes are coming now. So, Safa Hadi coming on for Bashir Rezan. He's really run himself into the ground this evening. Seems a little bit perturbed that he's going off, but he's going to have to follow instructions in that regard. And the other player going off is Bella Abdul Zahra, the captain. Giving his armband away. Ahmed Ibrahim will take it. And Sherko Karim coming on in his place. So it's a forward for a forward with that change. A couple of opportunities this evening for the captain that went begging. He certainly put a shift in, there's no question about that. So, about 8 minutes of normal time remaining. Good skill from Mahmoud Kamis. And good work from KO, retaining possession. Mabkut going deep to Lima, trying to ghost past the defender, but stumbles as he does so. Sebastian Tagliabue, the veteran striker there on the left of screen. Prolific scorer for Al Wahda and then Al Nasser here in UAE domestic football. There's frustration from the UAE fans, not happy with what they've seen. It is a draw tonight, and that will be three home games for the UAE, and just 2 points from them. You need to win your home games, goes without saying in this cutthroat qualification. Substitute, Ayman Hussein. The flag has gone up on this near side, so there must have been an offside in the build-up. There's confirmation of it. We'll have another look at it here. Touch and go, you'd have to say. There's the time for some late drama here. Both sides could certainly relish it. Here's the substitute, Mubarak. Down he goes under challenge. Gets the free kick. Frustration there for Sherko Karim. Just come on. This isn't quite to the pace of the action as yet. Cup's clear. Ahmed Ibrahim, chance for Sherko Karim to run. Concedes the free kick again though. Shaheen Abdulrahman. Too cute there from Khalfan Mubarak, giving away possession. Chance to run on this near side for Maui. Looks to play in Bayesh. The retention of possession from him. They had the opportunity to clear there, the UAE, and they didn't. They've played themselves into a bit of trouble. Ali Aboud has done well here. The give and go from him. Looking for the ball back from Ayman Hussein, doesn't get it. Abdullah Ramadan now looking for Ali Mabkoud. He wasn't necessarily aware the ball was coming. He's done well though. Gets the ball over. Can't get it past the defender with Kalfan Mubarak lurking at the back post. End to end stuff now as the players tire. On that far side, Treko Karim feeds the ball inside to Alamari. Shot comes in, it's blocked. Both sides know the importance of the 3 points here. And here come Iraq now. Well, these two sides drew on this ground in January, 0-0. So little to choose between them, just a handful of places in the FIFA rankings. And it's illustrated again here, isn't it, with this scoreline. Surely that's got to be offside on that far side. Treko Karim completely mistimed his run. As you can see, he's way beyond even Mahmoud Kamis, who was just dawdling on the edge of the penalty area. You can vote for your future star. You can use Twitter. Mabkoud, little give and go. He gets it back. Ali Mabkoud, great block, fantastic block by Ahmed Ibrahim. Great defending at the death. And now Iraq can perhaps capitalise on that good piece of defensive work. It's a good run, this, by the substitute Karim. Laid the ball back to Ali Aboud, who gets a second bite at the cherry. Picked up now by Bayesh. Can't get the better of Mahmoud Kamis, though. And the pace of the attack drawn. Shot from distance. And it's wide of the mark from Safa Hadi. It must have taken a deflection. Indeed, it did. Just came off Abdullah Ramadan. And so that will be a corner. The Iraqi fans just sensing possibly that they could secure for long periods in this match would have been considered an unlikely 3 points. Corner then for Amir Alamari, the man whose ball into the danger area caused such problems for the UAE and led to the own goal by Mohamed Alatas. Deep breath for Alamari. Keeper is the call from Ali Kashif, and he gathers it well. Just about 2 minutes of normal time remaining. Well, for both these teams, this isn't really the result they were looking for. I said at the outset that they both really needed 3 points tonight. Keep in touch with Iran and South Korea at the top of the table. A draw, not really much use to either team, although it does move them a point further on. All of a sudden, though, it looks as though third place will be the height of their ambitions in this group. Oh, and all of a sudden, it's there for the substitute who scored! Oh, yes! Ayman Hussein right at the death! Iraq has surely won it. Oh, look at the reaction on the bench. It was a fantastic dummy that set up Hussein. And he was calmness personified there. Slotted it home with his right foot. Oh, Bert van Marwijk. Dirham, for your thoughts. That's a great dummy, though. It really is. And it was that man, Amir Alamari, who let the ball run, the ball into the danger area by Maui. Superb dummy by one substitute and a great finish by the other. couple of touches just to compose himself and slotted it home so nicely. It's his sixth goal for Iraq, Ayman Hussein. I didn't see the yellow card. I'm pretty sure he's been booked for taking his shirt off, but he won't mind. And I don't think many Iraqi fans will mind either. Right at the death, Ayman Hussein. And there's confirmation, in fact, that he was yellow carded. No surprise there. Standard procedure. And we're into added time. Fourth official holding up the board. Yusuke Araki, 5 minutes, a minimum of 5 minutes to be played. And all of a sudden, the UAE will be absolutely desperate to even settle for a point here. Well, on match day three, Vietnam got a late equaliser against China to draw it back to 2-2. And then China, in added time, got a winner. So no strangers to drama in this group and indeed in this country. It was at the Sharjah Football Stadium. And a substitute there, Ayman Hussein. A little bit of argy-bargy with Majid Hassan. The adrenaline flowing through the veins of the Iraqi number nine, I'm sure. Tremendous stuff. Tenacious stuff from the visitors. Been on the back foot for long periods in this match. But they've played with discipline. And it looks as though they're going to get some reward. And it looks as though, too, there's going to be some changes here for the UAE right at the death. Sebastian Tagliabue is coming on for Keo Canedo as they search desperately for a goal. And also coming off left back Mahmoud Kamis. And in his place, Khalil Al Hamadi. So is there time for either of those two players to make any sort of contribution at all towards even a point for the UAE? 2 minutes already of the five to be played, a minimum of five, have been used up. Majid Hassan, is there a way through? De Lima, been lively on that right-hand side, dinks the ball forward. And in the end, good defensive work from Ahmed Ibrahim. A cushioned header, Ali Mabkut. And a dirham for his thoughts as well, because he had the opportunity at 1-0 and didn't take it. And all of a sudden, after that, the match has turned on its head. First with the own goal, and then with that terrific finish, composed finish from Ayman Hussein. The UAE can come forward again now. And towards the danger area. Oh, surely, yes, Mabkut, yes! He's done it! 2-2! Oh, yes! Ali Mabkut! Oh, that's what it means. Banda Alababi almost in tears. We've still got 2 minutes of the minimum of five to be played. And Mabkut's popped up with his second goal of round three. And his 13th goal of these qualifiers. It looked as though the ball had got away from him there. The cross came in. It was Walid Abbas, the substitute, who put it into the danger area. And Mabkut just managed to poke the ball home. Well, you want drama, you've got it here at the Zabil Stadium this evening. Two late goals, and we're all locked up again at two apiece. Well, given they were trailing going into injury time, the UAE will probably settle for a point now. But still, they'll have wanted three at the start of the evening. Clear by Shaheen Abdulrahman. The cheer comes up from the UAE fans. They want one final assault forward. Bursting forward is Mubarak, and that's a poor ball from him. And the supporters let him know. Hooked forward now, Walid Abbas again, creator of that equaliser. Abdullah Ramadan trying to jink clear. Gets it to Walid Abbas, overcooks the cross. Banda Alababi into the danger area. The header back. Oh, what a save! Fantastic stop, it's still alive. The header again, it's off the line by Ahmed Ibrahim. Oh, what drama at the back end of this match. Referee trying to keep a lid on things. But what a stop that was from Farhad Talib. Let's have another look at things. Banda Alababi dinked the ball back in. Tagliabue won the header. And the shot came in from the substitute, Kalfan Mubarak. And then it was off the line from Ahmed Ibrahim. So close to a dramatic winner for the UAE. There's a VAR check going on here as well. The AR official, Hiroyuki Kimura, just liaising with Ryoju Satou, our referee. Was it over the line, the ball? Goodness me. Some of the UAE supporters have seen that in the main stand. So close, wasn't it? Cheering, and in fact it's gone up on the big screen as goal. Oh, Banda Alababi in tears. What's happened? There are players down. Has the final whistle gone, I wonder? It looks as though the final whistle has gone. The match has ended in utter confusion. Even though goal went up on the screen, it's now been changed once again. And it's back to 2-2, and it is the end of the match. Well, you couldn't have a more dramatic ending than that, could you? The referee saying that's it. He blew his whistle, and there was a section of support that thought that a goal had been given. It was, in fact, the final whistle. The decision was that the whole of the ball hadn't crossed the line. What a match that has been. Keio Canedo giving UAE the lead in the first half. Iraq came back in the second through a Mohamed Al-Attas own goal after a good ball in from substitute Amir Al-Amari. And then right on the 90 minutes, Ayman Hussein seemed to have won it for Iraq before Ali Mabkut popped up 3 minutes into stoppage time and levelled matters up. And you can see Dick Van Marwijk having a word with the match official, Mr. Satou, Ryoju Satou. Well, he was under real pressure there at the end, wasn't he? As indeed was the VAR official. Everyone thought a goal had been given there. It came up on the big screen. But in the end, it wasn't a goal. So 2-2 then. At the end of this match, a dramatic evening at the Zabil Stadium. I hope you've enjoyed the action. Please stay with us as the road to Qatar continues. Thank you.